What's up, everybody? Today I'm making a fire boss. This guy's like it's a new boss. Stoked about this. Been working on the fire dungeon lately. You just constantly take damage. Unless you have a certain item which protects you from the fire damage. So let me get the code set up. So we're working in a fire dungeon. And we'll go to the boss and start making this guy awesome. Wondering if I should make him. Yeah, let's do this as Dungeon 7. What's up, Zilton? Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna put the player in Dungeon 7. And how you been, Zilton? What's up? Okay, so I'm looking for the boss. Oh, it's right there. Nothing much is up. Oh, but your stomach. Damn. Okay, first thing to do is start the data for this new boss. Wait, do I have a bosses? I do have a bosses. I'm gonna start with the synth fire, because it's kind of what I have in mind for this boss. It's basically just like an awesome version of synth fire. Oh no, you had chicken, then frozen yogurt, then a pound of a Red Bull. Man, you're living on the edge. God damn. All right, now we need a foe type. Let's go boss 4, I guess. Or 7. Hell, let's put this as 7. Fire boss. One of them. We gotta make sure this is not the swordless dungeon. And that should be it. We'll see if this works. You got an A star and ECDL? What's ECDL? What's up, Jonah? Welcome, welcome. Which is the fastest way to force him? Oh, I guess this guy is the drop boss. So I might as well just change this guy to be the fire boss. And we'll start making him. Oh man, I forgot about the double blink bug. No, I haven't tried it yet. Well, let me try it right now. What's up, Pedro? Hey, congratulations, your first interview. So if I have blink, so you had blink. not sure how it all worked out with your data, but I'll try the ice blink and the regular blink together. See if that works. Yeah, good luck, man. I hope your interview goes great. Well, I guess we're gonna have to craft this. So you had blink assigned to your L button, which means that you probably had a default there set to blink. So if I have level 3 blink and I craft it with whatever, so it didn't map it to anything here, but if I go outside the room, what jib is that? That was the droidsmith. Okay, and when I come out, okay, I do have two of them mapped. Awesome. So I'm going to save like that. Take a look at what the data looks like. I got blink and blink 2 mapped. So that's how it worked. Okay. And then if I go back to where I was, I'm not getting a double blink though. I'm getting a regular blink. Yeah, it's not. It's only going the regular distance for me. Wait a minute, that was weird. I'll try another one. Maybe it's the... Oh, press them both? No, I was asking you what that is. What's ECDL? So I'll press both buttons at once. Oh, that's cool. Nice. Wow, that's kind of cool. Well, so there's that. It's almost kind of nice. It's a pretty rad glitch, actually. Wow, cool. Okay, let me put some notes down about that. Okay, now I got some notes. I can e more easily either decide to keep the glitch or what. English computer driving license? But you got an A star in it? What's an A star? I'm assuming that's good. A star is good. That's crazy. You guys have the name of a cool algorithm as a grade. We got A plus and A minus over here. You guys have A star? That's crazy. Okay, starting off with this fire boss guy. I'm starting off with this the look of the fire synth drop or the fire wizard guys, these red guys. That's what I'm starting off as. So this guy can fire these fireballs at you, but I want him to do a lot more kinds of things. I want him to be able to move faster, so he's not going to look like this. He's not going to look like this guy, but I'm just leaving him looking like this at first, so that I can do the mechanics of him all. I want to get all his attacks going, so as rapidly as possible. So his attacks are going to be 1, he's got the fireball, 2, he's got this thing that is like a fire trail. So he shoots out a whole bunch, like a fireball basically, and leaves a whole trail of fire everywhere. And then another one, he can really quickly move across the whole screen and leave a whole fire trail as well. So I need the fire armor to be able to be in here without taking damage the whole time. You accidentally patch it out, don't patch it back in. Why would you say that? Oh, they're switching to numbers? Whoa. He's fired backwards. Nice one. Okay, first of all, he's gonna move faster. Thinking he might be a flying enemy. Okay, now for him to do his attack where he moves across the screen really quickly and leaves a fire trail, basically I'm gonna start with trying to make his behavior tree spawn fire. So he's gonna spawn a whole bunch of fire entities and I'm not sure if I can just do that. No, if I just try to spawn a fire entity, that won't work. So I need to make it so it can work. I guess at first, instead of breaking everything else, which might happen if I do this by changing this file, then I'm gonna copy this file to fire 2, and then play around with it, and then later on I can merge it back. So all right, that's where the hell is it? Weapons. I believe there's a method called create fire, right? Yeah, create fire, this is what it is. It creates actually a light entity and then adds a damaging fire. And then also adds something so it automatically fades out after a minute. Okay, so I'm going to combine everything from the light and this damaging entity all into the fire too. So this is going to be under its attributes. So it has a collision component. Collagen? It has a collagen component. Category shot neutral. None block size, so size is 1B. Damage. Whatever you give it for this damage. Create fire. What's a typical damage for fire? One. Damage one. So that's going to be damage 0.25. Okay, we got a collision set up. Now we need the other parts of the light. Okay, hopefully this will work. Let's hope. Oh man, did I? Oh, the whole. Oh, I edited fire. Damn. There we go. Fire two. All right. So we have fire, we have fire two. Now, maybe the fire boss can drop some of these fire twos, like sequence. Spawn fire two, maybe. So if this works, while the guy's walking, he'll drop some fire. They immediately died. Fire 2, missing input component. Okay. Fire boss, immune to fire. About immune to shot? Oh, that's shot. Oh, because it's shot neutral. How about if this category for the fire is just fire? So how about if it's shot foe, fire? Oh yeah, now the player can definitely be hurt. Okay, cool. It's a good start for an independent fire entity. Now it just needs to burn out after a second. Which should be possible using a behavior tree. So give this a pretty simple behavior where after a second, timer begin, timer, like how long does this thing live for? Let's see, how long does the other kind of fire live for? Two point 2 seconds. That's the delay. Yeah, and then the duration of the fade out. So it should live for actually 3.33 seconds. No, Jonah, yeah, for now it does mean that, but no, it doesn't mean that in the long run. The point is that right now I've got fire. I need to play with the flags so that the player can be hurt by enemy fire, but not by its own fire. So the same thing with the enemies, you know, and the bosses and stuff like that. I just need to clarify the flags because right now there was never an entity that ever needed the player never needed to be caught on fire because the player was always the one creating fire. So now I just need to make it so that if the player creates the fire, it also adds like a player flag or whatever. So the player knows that it shouldn't be hurt by its own fire, but then the enemies. So basically, I just got to play with the flags. But yeah, eventually the boss will be able to be hurt by your fire. But not this boss. Not this boss. This is the fire boss. Can't ever be hurt by fire. But you get the point. Talur, that's a custom scripting language I wrote for this game. It uses behavior trees. Okay, so 3.33. Not bot. Fire boss. Fire two. Okay, so timer. Set the timer to 3.33. 3.33 or so, and then yeah, sequence. That's the initial sequence. This is the remove self sequence. Just remove if timer is less than zero. Okay, so basically that's it. It's got two sequences. So the fire should remove itself after 3 seconds. But it's not going to fade out, so I need to worry out, get it so it can fade out. So, one, two, three. It's still there. So it didn't work. Okay, so I guess I'll turn on debugging and see what's going on with the AI when it drops it. So, next time it'll drop some fire. Oh, this entity does not have. I'm not sure if this entity even has a behavior component, basically an AI component. It's not giving me any text. Oh, there it is. Okay, wait, there. Oh, it's just like initial. Why is that? Oh. I had timer begin. I was trying to set the timer to begin. Now it needs to be if timer begin, do the timer, and then once it's done, remove. There it goes. Cool. So we got, they're being removed, but they're not being faded out yet. Cool. All right. So now I just got to get them to fade out nicely. So before I was using this all in code, and I was using this function called shrink light, which shrinks its light component over a moment. So I'm trying to think of how I should put this into the existing behavior tree system. Do I plan to create every element's dungeon? I don't know. I don't know at this point. Got a lot of work ahead of me with this, with these dungeons and stuff. And I don't quite, I mean, I have sketches of every, like, so many kinds of dungeons, and enemies and stuff. Like, oh, I got all these sketches, but like, which ones do I do? Which ones are going to be fast to implement? Which ones are going to be slow? You know, what, I don't know, I'm not exactly sure at this point. To be honest, I'm kind of overwhelmed because there's so much left to do with this game, and I feel like I should be more done than I am. So, you know, it's the game supposed to come out this year, and like, there's so much left to do. But we were talking about that on a stream the other day, and we got a pretty good solution in mind. So how to shrink these light components? How to call a freaking function from that scripting language, basically, without, you know, but doing it the right elegant way. Yeah, I don't know right now. I'm just going to keep going with this guy and get his basic behaviors going. So, yeah, this is kind of a cleanup task anyway, is to get the light to fade out correctly. That's definitely a cleanup-y type of task. So the next thing I want him to do is to leave a trail of fire as he's moving. So the fire boss right now just spawns fire. All right, so we'll have a sequence. Leave fire. We'll call if dir any. Mode 0? Wait, what's mode 1 again? Mode 1's when he's stuck. Alright, yeah, so mode 0. Dir any, target any. Spawn fire 2 and delay a little bit. Thank you. what he's doing. Oh, I should have turned on the debug to figure that out. All right, let's try that a little less time and. How about if not stuck? Yeah, that definitely helped. Looks like he was getting stuck. Kind of nice. I like seeing them leave a trail like that. What's going on with the doors? What's up, Space My Name? Alright, so the next general thing I wanted to do. I want them to move faster, actually. Get him up to 150. Whoa. How he can get stuck in these corners. So maybe I need to have some kind of different room design here. Okay, so if he's gonna move that fast, he needs to drop fire faster. Snipe, what's up, man? How would you like the method invocation to appear in your Valtree script? What? What are you talking about? I don't even know what a method invocation is. Define method invocation. It's a Java word, huh? What's up, Boogie? Welcome, man. I'm not sure what you mean, Born to Snipe. Oh. Yeah, no, I don't know. I don't actually want to call a method for my script. There's a piece of code that I have that fades out fire, and I want to find an elegant way to basically have the entity of the little fire entities fade themselves out and fade out their light component. And so it's not that I want to call a method from this script. I just want to find some way for this script to elegantly fade out those fire entities. So so yeah, there's never anything in here which like calls a method or anything. These are all just scripting little bits of. Yeah, I'm not sure if I want a trigger word in the script. I'm not sure if that's how the right elegant solution or not. Like I said, this is kind of a cleanup thing, right? So I can at least get this boss working for now and get him to do like, you know, all of his things. And then I'd like to draw him and make him look better. And then I can do the cleanup. Like, okay, just make these little fire entities fade out. It'll be pretty simple. And having a whole day to think about it will help me to find a more elegant solution. Oh, no worries, man. No worries. I hit a 4-hour, 20-minute stream. slowing down. This is weird. Yeah, so I'm running at 20, now 7 frames a second, 5 frames a second. Why is it so slow? I think it might have something to do with the doors there constantly popping up. Oh wow. This is so slow. Oh wait, yeah, it's still supposed to start at 30. Okay, it's running okay now. I think after a second though it's gonna start to run slower. Yeah, now it's running at 20. Oh, but now it's back up. But now it's down to 15. Oh, probably because there's so many fire entities. I don't know. What's again? That's the cleanup task. I'm trying to do cleanup tasks while I haven't even finished creating this guy. Okay, so the next thing I want him to do is be able to shoot a fire, shoot basically kind of like a fireball, except that it leaves a fire trail. Yeah, so it'll kind of be like an entity like the fireball, except that it drops fire just like this guy does. Yeah, is that what it is, Chasset? Chasset 19, man, it's been a while since you've been on the stream. We talked about Dark Tower last time you were here. How you been, man? Yeah, something's wrong with this. There's got to be something wrong with what I'm doing there, Well, I know, for example, every one of those lights is having a light component, and a light component adds a lot of computation to the blend shader in this game. So that's why it's because it's creating light. The light is a pretty computationally expensive. Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm good. Just making this game. I'm getting close to finishing Songbringers, but not really. I mean, it's in the last. It's definitely in the last. Quarter, half, definitely in the last quarter. It's got to be at least the last quarter of this game. All right, so I guess I'll create copy the fireball and create the fire trail. All right, and he'll have two kinds of shoot. And we'll launch a fire trail. It's at least 3% complete. It's definitely at or above 3%. Yeah, cool, right? I know, I put it on TIGSource and I'm at 80. Which sounds right. When you think about it, and if you put it according to my version numbers, I just did that according to version numbers. This is version 0.86 or something. So. This guy's crazy. Alright, so the fire trail just drops a bunch of fire. So it'll have a behavior. Leave fire if. Just really don't need to check if there are any, if target, any, if mode. So yeah, if we're not stuck. Yeah. Thank you. there we go. Cool. Yeah, that was kind of neat. I mean, it'd be cooler, though, if he... when he did that. Yeah, actually... The fire trail, I don't even want it to have a fireball. I'm going to take out all this fireball. And even give it an empty format. So the fire trail will just look like it's like fire just coming out. There's a fireball. Yes, that's nice. That's pretty cool. Except the only thing that sucks is that he keeps moving in a different direction. Okay, how about if he tries to circle you, that would be pretty sweet. That would be the ultimate intelligence for this guy. I'm thinking if he starts to do his fire trail, he should change to... Oh, he does do target none already. But maybe... Or, I mean, dir none. But maybe target none. So he has to get a target and also delay a little longer. So maybe 2 seconds until he does anything. How can I get him to circle around you? Dungeon though, Chasid. This is the fire dungeon. This is a different dungeon here. Check it out. There's a whole bunch of dungeons, and this one is a special dungeon called the fire dungeon, where everything is on fire the whole time. So yeah, let me show you what I mean. Gotta turn off some code to be able to show you. Yeah, so this is what it looks like normally. Except for this guy, this little bit here. Right, so this is what the game normally looks like. The lights are a lot better. You're looking at the fire dungeon. You're not now, but before you're looking at the fire dungeon, which is a totally new thing, and I'm still trying to figure out how... You know, I just created it this week, so there's a lot of stuff to be fixed as far as the frame rate goes, and as far as the graphics go, and stuff like that. Okay, so back to this room. Everything up. There we go. Yeah, okay, that time he shot the fire trail in one direction, and then he moved in the other direction. That time... That's pretty cool. Okay, so he should have a longer delay. So when he does the fire trail, he's going to chill out for a whole 3 seconds. Maybe 3.5, actually. Okay, so now I guess it's time to start fighting him. Let's see what it feels like. I'm just doing these pillars constantly coming out. See this? It keeps on adding more and more and more of these pillars. I don't know why. I think that might be caused the start of this frame rate issue. Part of it, I mean. Do a show FPS. Shitload of birds, that's for sure. Okay, so it adds a lot of birds when it's doing the fire. Of birds, wow. And the GL calls go through the roof. Holy crap, why are we up to 2,600 GL calls? So check this out. That the fire all went away right there, and then but it still had. This might have something to do with 60,000 verts. Holy crap. No wonder it's slowing down. I wonder if it has to do with the fire being composed of multiple entities, or perhaps that the light component is not even being removed. Or another thing is that the whole shadow system is being recreated every single time there's a single fire entity created. So. So fire 2, I'm gonna start taking away bits of it, like children. Say it doesn't have a child oval and no additive oval thing. Sucks because I can't really make this boss until I fix this bug. I can't really test him out because he's so crapping things out right now. Okay, how about the light component? Is it the light? Let's see if we take out the light component. So now it doesn't have a child, doesn't have any like opponent either. Oh, and particles. Dang, let's get rid of these particles. Oh, it just could be the particles, actually. Particles add a ton. Each one has a tiny little sprite. And, oh, and they might not be being deleted somehow. Oh, I hope it's that. Yeah, so we start with 100 GL calls. Yeah, check it out. He just did a bunch of fire. He only still has 300 GL calls, 400. Let's see. Hope it goes back down. No, it doesn't. Something is being left behind. After all that, I got rid of all those things, and this is all still... Fuck this. I'm gonna work on the art. I'm working on the art. I really want to draw this guy, get his main behaviors finished today on today's stream. So I can worry about the details of the debugging and all that later. So go to foes, and I think I'm gonna start with the synth fire guy. I know, they add up pretty damn quick, right? Yeah, something's being left behind, for sure. What's up, Arcane? Welcome, welcome. Okay, so I'm gonna crack out my graphics tablet and this guy, and I'm gonna play with some art. I'm thinking this guy will be kind of a floating guy, a floating kingly, wizardly looking guy. This is his idol? What is this one? Oh, this is where he's walking. Let's start with his idol. So he's going to be floating up in the air a bit. I want him to have big old armor. Nice. Nice, right on, Minecraft. Yeah, he's not gonna have a hood. I'm thinking he has like a crown, so he's like a king or something. You think you should have massive squared shoulders, huh? This is kind of cool actually having him have a totally black face. From Grunkle-stan from Gravity Falls? Yeah, that guy. I remember that guy. A levitating crown of fire. That's cool. I'm gonna get some fire colors in my palette. I'm gonna try out having him have like a kind of staff. Is that a yo-yo? Fire yo-yo, it's kind of a cool idea. It's a cool idea for sure. Yeah, I guess it would be kind of similar to the hat, huh? All right, let's see what these guys looks like. About approximately like that. I'm not done at all fit with this guy. I just want to see what he looks like so far. Boogie won the free parking again. Oh, yeah. I love seeing it. I love seeing that. Fireboss idol. Yeah, I know, right? And only 19 points. What's up with that? Come on. Come on, Bafu. How about 219 points? Definitely looked pretty cool there for a second. Okay, while he's moving, we get him to do the fire boss idol as well. Good. I'm somewhat happy with the overall proportions of this guy and his overall look. So I'm gonna start playing around with animating him and finishing up what his look will look like. Gotta finish look the looks gotta look Look here. The scepter bit is way too saturated. Do we get a flaming hat? Do you mean in the game? Do you get it? Are you able to craft a flaming hat? Yeah, you get the top hat, you combine it with fire, and you have a flaming top hat. Okay, so let's try out that idea of this guy having a crown of fire. Because that's going to be pretty determinant for the rest of this animation and everything, so... And oh, I want to put some runes and like scrolly type stuff here. Okay, one step at a time. I need to see if that worked with this sort of scroll, like bright scrolls on his shoulders like that. Seeing some highlights up there like that. There's no name for this guy yet. So far, he's just a fire boss. Feel free to shout out if you got an idea. Let's hear it. So I'm going to start with the crown, and since it's going to be, he's going to be floating all overall, I'm going to try the crown floating too, and start by drawing it. Oh, that's cool seeing it all small like that, actually. I was going to do way bigger, but I don't know. Can I name him Boogie Sherrill? El Fuablo? I get it, like Diablo and Fu. We got Steve, the Zombie King. Okay, let's see how that looks with the crown. Whoops. Whips. Emolf. Emolf? That's a cool name. The Plague. Oh, you're curious if he was a zombie and a king. No, he's not a zombie. He's more of like a demonic wizard. The Bloat. It's not lame. Important now. Cool. Okay, so I'm gonna play around with animating him a bit now. Actually, I'm gonna make him a little cooler first, because the second I start animating, everything starts getting stuck. Drawzoo, woof. Snake Spear, Sharkquakia. We've seen these before. If anybody doesn't know, we had this stream where we were trying to name this one guy for the whole, like, forever. We did all these different retries. We were like recounting votes and stuff. And Sharkisha was one of the names. So was Snakespear. I think Snakespear was the ending of the name. Emperor. Ah, that's pretty cool. Emperor, that's pretty neat. Aerith. Amber. William Tell. William Hell. So tell us the lore about this dude. I don't have any lore yet. Feel free to share lore if you want. We can creatively make up some lore for this guy right now. Name him Zilton. Shitan. Zilton the Jilted King. Pretty good. It's pretty good. Balls. Yeah, Balls is always a good name. Can't go wrong with Balls. During the Great War, the wizards join in to help the Dark Force, and this guy is the balls of the wizards. Drazu? That one's wizard backwards. That translates to Zilton wizard. Ah. Okay, I think I like him about like this. We'll do one more export. Was given the crown and queen, then his long lost elder brother returned, claimed the crown and his bride, and had it banished. He returned with his magic balls of fire as a master wizard in search of vengeance. That's why he's jilted. Oh, nice. I like it. Nice. He's got a backstory now. Okay, so to animate him, this is so easy. All he's got to do is float up and down. But I do want it to look pretty cool, so start it off. First of all, I can do some up and down motion. So now he's floating. Where he catches on fire? What's up, Red Sands? He traded his soul to the Songbringer version of Satan to become a powerful wizard to seek vengeance against his brother Fu. Or Fulcrum Ultimatum. Sounds like a transformer. Thanks, Red Sands. Oh, but he lost his individuality. But yeah, it's not really supposed. It's not supposed to be the Lich King. The Lich King. That's from The Lich King is a Let's make sure I'm not drawing the Lich King here. Did I accidentally draw the Lich King? No, this guy's frozen. E. But this guy's so awesome. This guy's pretty awesome for sure. Good job, fantasy art drawing people that did this. All right, so to make this animation look better, well, first of all, let's see how that looks in the game with him floating at that rate and all that. So, like Soul Eater or Fire Lord? Is he holding a matchstick? Alright, yeah, so he's definitely floating too fast. Like, way too fast. Maybe if he was floating more at a rate of like at least 0.2, maybe 0.3. Fulcrum Ultimatum is you. Also, what's that? Ah, see, that's better with him floating slower. Okay, now to animate the individual frames while he's floating. Yeah, I got the foo part. I got the foo part. You can be wizard brothers. Woo! I always wanted a wizard brother. Is he holding a matchstick? So I move things around a little bit here. In this frame. Match. Mitch the Match Wizard. Oh, these are getting so good. What's the difference between a wizard and a warlock? You tell me what is the difference? Is this a setup for a punchline or is this like an actual question? I'd love to hear a joke about this. Or the real truth. Either one. What is the difference? Can someone tell me? Fuego, good one. For most lore, what I've understood for is wizards are born with magic. Warlocks sold their souls for magic? Really? That's where you draw the line, huh? You just like, these people sold their souls. These people are all good because they didn't sell their souls. Kind of liked it more like that. Damn. Nikki Fire? So he's a zombie wizard? That's That's what somebody just asked that a second ago. Yes, crash a bike every world you try, and you shall. Brimstone Behemoth. The Chain Champion. Comcast. Yes, it's my nemesis, Comcast. There's gotta be an enemy named Comcast in this game, for sure. Hey, what's up, Salad Dogs? The damn Dark One, master of the waterproof matchstick. What's up, Darkness 9? All right, I'm gonna add a little bit of glow to his matchstick here. Henry? Cam Costa? Yeah, totally right. I definitely don't want to get sued. But yes, it'd be so funny to have an enemy named Comcast. Eternal? Infernal Ifrit. Ooh, that's, you're coming up with some good ones here, Zilton. Okay, we got a little glow there. Jared Joker. Limp Lyco Bearer. You love, man, you can name things all day, huh? Is that what you do? Do you just like name stuff all day? All right, that one's starting at 40. Master Match Stick. Necro Nightlight. Lumpy the Lich. Skip on Zero. All right, there's only one thing bugging me about this animation, and that's when he goes in and out with this. Yeah, both these two frames. Will he be able to spawn minions? I don't know yet. He's already spawning a lot of fire. Yes. Yes, I did change the light beams. Tough Tyke. The baby blobs on fire. Ooh, the baby blobs on fire would be a cool thing. Actually, I was gonna have a spider that was on fire, so maybe that would suffice as the tiny enemy. So like the Verloc could have fiery spiders, and maybe this guy could have fiery spiders too. That would be a pretty cool enemy to have this guy spawn, actually. Yeah. That would be pretty fun to have little tiny enemies that he spawn. Yeah, I'll try that right now. I'll try at least having him spawn some spiders or little blobs and see which one's more fun. Voracious Virelock? These all have merit. It's gonna be impossible to choose a name. Okay, let's see what he looks like in the game. Floating around like this. Spawn a meteor? Ooh, a meteor. Xylophone X-Man? Avatar of Banished Flames. You should respect your warlocks. Flies across the screen, he faces the wall for a minute. That's kind of stupid, but yeah, I'll figure that out and the GL draw calls and all that. It sucks with this bug here. I can't really debug, I can't really play the boss without it slowing down so fast. Okay, let's work on the animation where he shoots fire or something. Doomlander. Yeah, I got the Zoolander one from the Zoo Damner. Yeah, let's try some spiders really quick. Let's see what the spiders look like. If you can spawn some spiders, Firebot, we'll do it just like the Verloc does. to come out of his dress. Oh no! Oh, holy crap! Look at that! Oh, it's like... Instantly goes to 120,000 draw calls. Did you guys see that? Something is definitely wrong with my engine all of a sudden. It might be these spawns, actually, because I was spawning the fire and then spawning these spiders, and all of a sudden, it crashes like crazy bad. Look at this, he just doesn't even stop. Wow. How many spiders can there be on one screen? The player has gone into the... Whoa! I don't know what's going on. This is a great idea, though. Such a great idea. I'm just letting it roll. I mean, it's at 29,000 verts and still running somehow. Look at that. It says it's running at 60 frames a second, but I do not believe it. What is going on? Alright, enough of this fun. I know, right? I'm like, any second now, the stream's gonna crash because of that. Okay, I got it. If he's mode 0, we'll set mode 2 here so he can't spawn forever and ever and ever. What, your headphones were dying? Oh, see, that was all it was. It was just that he was spawning every single tick. This is cool. With them spawning spiders like that. Okay. I think I could do another animation. I got another animation in me today. Today's stream. I'm going to check this guy in though so far. This is pretty cool. Yeah, totally. They need to be on fire. Which... also is going to be crazy. Let's put less of these guys. Level? Oh man, that's not where those belong. Dope. Have them leave lava spots? That could be cool. Oh yeah, animating them on fire would be the right way to go. Good call, Boogie. Definitely, that would definitely take off the stress. I'm really sleepy today. I don't know why. Get status. Okay, so this one we don't need. This one we want to add. Mini fire elementals. Valve offers VR developers funding to avoid platform exclusive deals. Cool. Wow, prepaid Steam revenue. I know, platform exclusive. Chet, oh, I forgot about Chet. Chet and Eric. Is VR a thing? Heck yeah, man. All you need is Google Cardboard. That's all you need for. That's it. You don't need no HTC Vive. Okay, so how about an animation where he fires, he like shoots. Okay, I got an idea. I got an idea for this one. So I'll save this one as Fireboss Idle, Fireboss Shoot. I'm thinking like he tears open his, or not tears open, but like opens up the his robe in the middle right here, and he's got a bunch of fire. He's just like made of fire. Right, like an eye of fire, yeah. Oh, right, yeah. He just explodes into a ball of fire. Huh, I like that. Right? We were just talking about that yesterday about this particular dungeon here. You're constantly taking damage. So if you're a speedrunner and you're trying to like get through this dungeon fast, you might skip the item that gives you the armor against fire. And so you would be in the state where you could defeat the boss and then die right after defeating the boss because you didn't have enough health to win to live through it. That's not looking fiery enough. Okay, I'm gonna try it though. Just one frame where he's like, blam. This ought to give us a good indicator of if this is even gonna be right. So I only did one frame there, just to see if it's even gonna be remotely the right thing. Oh, it didn't like that. Oh, I named it wrong. Oh, I don't need a breath animation. Okay, this definitely needs work. Like, I want to see him sort of like tilt his head back a bit. Imagine his matchstick would be up in the air a bit. Maybe a lot. So what I'm doing here as far as like technique of how to animate is I'm starting with the last animation. Basically, this is the apex of this animation. The peak of this animation is this frame where he's got like he looks just like, you know, this is the peak of the animation, and then I'll work backwards and create all the animation, the other frames in between that need to be added. Need this glow in here. All right, see what that looks like. Missing something. I mean, besides the frames that need to be added to make it look smooth. He's looking really weird whenever he gets hurt, too, so I'm gonna add a hurt animation. Oh, I was so hoping it was Boogie again winning the free parking. Alright, so fire boss hurt. What the hell is going on? This might do for a single frame hurt animation. Yeah. like he only had like 4 hit points. So I hear my girl making dinner. I think this is about it for today's stream. It's a pretty good start, actually, for this guy. When I come back to working on this code and this art and everything for this guy later on tonight, first thing I need to do is work on these whatever's going wrong in the spawning system or something like that. It's creating so many GL verts and so many more GL draw calls. And I'm really excited about it, actually, because it might lead to... If I go off the screen, I can't go off the screen now. If I could go off the screen right now, I'd be able to tell if going off the screen resets all the GL verts and everything becomes okay all of a sudden. Because that might fix it, and then I would know that it's basically is creating entities, but it is removing the entities when it finally goes to another screen. I'm not sure what's happening. But I'll figure that out, and then all the GL draw calls will be fine, and the frame rate will run okay, and I can actually play this guy normally. And I gotta work on his animation for shooting. That's really a big thing there, and that needs to be better. It's kind of a cool concept that he opens up his robe, and he's like, his body is made of fire. I like that part, but it's just not quite coming across visually yet, so I gotta work on that. And yeah, maybe I'll do some little fire spiders or fire entities or something like that. These spawns, as well as his fire trails and all the other attacks he's got. And then putting them all together like that, once he's all together, it's just playing him and seeing how fun he is. So thanks for watching, everybody. Later, guys. And I'll catch you next time. Whenever that's going to be, I'm not actually sure. Tomorrow, maybe. So... have a great one. Appreciate y'all.